a lot of people approached me, I can tell you that, but you know, I can't think not coming back to CSK. Because of everything, you know, what we have been through, how we have conducted ourselves, how the management has been, how the players has been, how the fans have been. I always keep saying, you know, I've been, it's like a second home to me. You know, the fans over here, they've literally adopted me. They accept me as one of their own. So there can't be any bigger compliment than that. And yes, we have got fans everywhere. Yes, at the same time, I would say wherever I go, whether I'm batting, bowling, fielding, doing anything, you know, I get the appreciation, I get the love. But this is a special place, so that thought of being with any other franchisee was never a question. In fact, the last 2 years that we have not played, you know, our fan following got stronger and stronger. You know, because none of the players were involved with anything. We respect our fans, but we never did an outstanding campaign only for the fans. Because we knew if we take care of our cricket and if we put all our 200% focus on cricket, the fans will be there. Because this side of the country has very strong understanding of the game. And in fact, you know, we have the biggest fan base all across the country. And it's because of the fans that I can proudly say where we are right now. A lot of it is because of the love that we get everywhere. You know, I was never a captain before I captained the Indian cricket team. So that itself answers the question. And the second thing is a wicketkeeper is always a vice captain, you know, irrespective of whether he's the captain or not, because he's somebody who's in a position where he watches the game very closely. He understands the angle. He understands how the bowler is bowling, what is the pace of the wicket, how the batsman is batting. So I don't think it's a difficult job. And I feel before a few of us, you know, the wicketkeepers started captaining the side was regarded as, oh, they already have too much burden. Why to burden the keepers more with giving them captainship? But stats have proved that wicketkeepers have actually been very good captains. Maybe because they're so close to the game, they understand what the problem is. They understand what people are going through or what the bowler is going through. So they actually have very good analysis of the game. So I feel it shouldn't be a problem. But again, captainship is, you need to have a good team, and then you know you can maneuver the resources. If the resources are not good, you know, it doesn't matter who the captain is, whether it's Ricky Ponting, Steve Waugh, or any other Clive Lloyd, any other greatest captain in the world. So you need to have a good, strong team, and then you can motivate them, and you know, if it's needed, or maneuver around with the players to perform so that they perform well on the field.